I woke up, freezing. It was exactly 3 a.m. 3 a.m. is the demonic witching hour. It's a way for demons to mock the Holy Trinity. It's an inversion of 3 p.m., the miracle hour, which is traditionally accepted as the hour of Christ's death.
Why it's this close, they talking about there's no evidence that I ever sodomized, but even though you put that all over the paper, and every time they take a quote out of this courtroom, they take a quote from out of her mouth, which is, you know, the stuff to put me in jail. It's nothing that's been true. I just want print the facts so everybody can sort it out. My life is ruined because nobody has a chance to get the facts.
That there was no semen found.
No semen found, no forceful entry, no entry into the anal, no nothing, none of that, you know.
And no fingerprints on the
gun. No fingerprints on the guns, you know what I'm saying?
What is your response to the allegations that were brought by the district attorney in Santa Barbara that you molested this boy?
Totally false. If I would hurt a child, I would slit my wrists. I would never hurt a child. It's totally false. I was outraged. I could never do something like that.
This is all about my image. This has nothing to do with me. This is all about my image. It's like MTV, all the papers, they building me up. Now they destroying me on the same image that they perpetuated.
Thank you for, you know, giving me the opportunity to be heard, you know, in a positive light.
Yeah.
Or just in a fair light. I first came to Arizona, man, and I remember one day coming from the studio at 6 o'clock in the morning and pulling over on the highway. We like four cars, you know, just to watch the sunrise. And it was at that point that I fell in love with Arizona. I said, you know what, this has to be God's country, you know, because I'd never seen anything as beautiful as that sunrise. Then I met the devil in God's country. You know, and it's not so much who, it's what, you know, what happens and the things that the devil does. It's not so much a person, even though he acts through people. You know, you can't call one person the devil.
Joe Arpaio?
You know, you can't call any one person the devil. You can't do that because no one person has enough power to be the devil, you know? And, you know, it's through all these hardships that I realized that, you know what? This is God's country because I met the devil here. Because if I hadn't met the devil here, I wouldn't realize I was strong enough to overcome the obstacles that the devil would place in my path. And it's by overcoming these obstacles that I realized that this is God's country. Because he helped me get over these obstacles. He helped me get over these hurdles.
Okay, so but when you're done here, when you're out of here.
I'm not looking back.
You're not coming back?
No, I'm not coming back. I'm not coming back for a show. I'm not coming back for a visit. I'm not even driving through the states. If I'm in a plane and they gotta fly over it, I'm gonna go around, okay? You deserve the same grace. You know, whether I know you or not, I pray for my friends, family, loved ones, and as well as my enemies every night, you know, because we're all God's children. We're all God's children, and we all deserve the same grace.
I think people are curious how a guy, you've sold how many records?
28 million.
And made millions and millions of dollars.
Yeah.
How did you end up in here?
I think everyone who's watching knows how I ended up in here.
I don't know if they do.
I'm pretty sure they do. Anytime you get it, I'm pretty sure they do. You know, there's how do I end up in here?
Why you keep going back to Miami?
Yeah. Well, I have a fiance in Miami, and I have a new, have a baby, 3 months. Yep, I miss all my kids, man. I miss my kids. That's the hardest part about this. I miss my kids. But,
do they come and see you?
No, they're in school and stuff like that. You know, my baby will be here in a couple of days, though. My baby will be here in a couple of days. My baby will be here. Don't judge me. Well, you shouldn't judge anyone. But don't have an assumption on who I am until you've met me.